Greetings one, greetings all. 24th of April 2009. Beautiful day. I thought I'd just stand in front of my apple blossom tree. Every now and again a story comes along and it makes you go, what on earth is this country coming to? And then you move on and you forget all about it. But I don't want to forget about this story because it's indicative of what is happening in the country today. Just have a listen to this for a minute.
The room at Rosalind Figg's house in Coventry. Her 86-year-old mother Betty was staying here when four police officers, two social workers and a doctor came to the house. They broke down the door with a battering ram and then removed her, taking her back into the Buttscroft nursing home. This video, which was filmed by a neighbour, appears to show a blanket being thrown over Betty's head as she was taken away from her daughter's house. Betty Figg herself had apparently asked if she could stay with her daughter. Rosalind says they took her out of Buttscroft, but were then told they'd had to take her back in by 6:30 one evening. At a quarter to midnight, police came to her house. Rosalind says she showed them her mum sleeping peacefully and they left, but then 2 days later they returned with social workers and more officers. Mrs. Figg was put in a wheelchair and taken to a waiting car.
Okay, that news report was from Telegraph TV. Okay, so let's have a few of the basic facts of this case. Mrs. Betty Figg was in care in a nursing home. The family being Miss Rosalind Figg, the daughter, pay £2,200 a month for her care. The daughter decided that she would be better served if she came and lived with her. She adapted her house, she gave up her job, she gave up her business and took the lady from the nursing home and had her nicely, safely tucked up in her own bedroom, in her own palace, basically, somewhere down in Coventry. Mrs. Betty Figg and Miss Rosalind Figg had a visit from the social services of Coventry County Council or City Council Social Services, who said they thought she would be better off served in the nursing home. The daughter refused and said, well, no, I don't think so. Explain the reasons why. Communication, isn't it? And social services went away. Well, they didn't actually, because they came back 2 days later, mob armed with police. You don't want that, do you? Who had a battering ram to batter down the door in order to take the great-grandmother back to the nursing home. According to Colin Green, who was a spokesman, said that it's in the best interests of the grandmother. You know, she's vulnerable, she needed to go to a place of safety. They'd even gone so far as to section her under the Mental Health Act. And she now resides, presumably, in that nursing home. Anyway, social services came, as I say, the police were there to enforce the arrest. The grandmother was bundled into a wheelchair and had her face covered. I mean, you've got to have a look at the video to see. I mean, it's disgusting. But we'll stick with the facts. And then bundled into a car and taken away. The daughter wasn't able to come out. She was visibly upset. She was very upset with the thought that the police were going to batter her door down. However, she has gone public with this, and, you know, thank God for that. The neighbours are absolutely outraged by it. That is the story as it is at the minute. Okay, those are the bare basic facts. We now need to interpret some of those facts. Okay, fact number one, we'll talk about Mrs. Betty Figg, who has senile dementia. She's been cared for in a nursing home. Now, she belongs to a family, obviously a close-knit family. And I think it's quite natural that the daughter would have, you know, a lot of concern for her mother. You know, it's a stressful thing anyway. Her mother has senile dementia, for God's sake. Of course the daughter is, you know, she's stressed up to the eyeballs, isn't she? And, you know, she believes what she's doing for familial reasons is right by her mother. And God bless her for that. Mrs. Figg was sectioned under the Mental Health Act. Now, you know, and I know probably, that the Mental Health Act is designed for basically stroppy people who refuse treatment. It's not the family who are put under a Mental Health Act or a situation that's put in them under the Mental Health Act. It is the individual who's put under the Mental Health Act, and it is generally, in the sense, in, you know, the sense of the law itself, the sense of the act, is that that person is a danger to themselves or others by their actions, or indeed by their inactions. That's how they get around this. And this poor lady has been subject to the Mental Health Act, totally against the spirit of the act, I might hasten to say, because we know, and I know, that we're talking about 6'6" schizophrenics who live with their elderly mother. The mother needs them out, not needs them in. That is what the act was actually designed for, not for frail old ladies, not. We also talk about communication here. Now, unfortunately, people with mental illness or mental disorders, with dementia, with any human being, basically, communication is key, isn't it? And if we can't trust them to communicate with the Fig family, how on earth can we trust them to communicate with Mrs. Betty Fig? I don't quite see how that adds up. Just to say about Colin Green, who was the spokesman on her case, you've got to have a look at the video, but I mean, he's a director of Young People Services. He's got nothing to do with the elderly. I don't quite know why they would send him out. Maybe the person in charge of that case went on holiday. I don't know. Other things, and this is the main thing. It's an attack on the family. Families now have no bearing, have no status in this country anymore. Absolutely amazing. Families have no status, have no legal status. And why is that? Because on one hand, they take £2,200 per month off the family to pay for the mother's care, and yet the family have no legal recourse to look after that lady. The other thing is, if for example Rosalind had taken the lady to the nearest hospital and left her there, the first thing that comes out in when you get admitted to hospital is your discharge plan. They can't wait to get rid of you. But you know why, don't you? That's because they are paying for it, not you. In this case, because Rosalind is paying the fee, of course they want her in a nursing home. Of course they do. If it was Coventry paying, do you think she would be in that nursing home? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. It's one of those stories that, again, it's flagged up, and it's probably happening time and time again. It's caught the attention because Rosalind Fig has not idly lied down. She's called everyone she can think of to, in order to protect herself and to protect her mother. She's unhappy with the care. Now, I have no comment to make on the nursing home. I don't know. I don't know the issues there. All I know is that communication is always key, and social services, I'm afraid, have been guilty of a lack of communication. I want to know also why the police, I mean, we were talking about the bamboo joint yesterday or the day before. Why are the police policing food and great-grandmothers? Why aren't they policing the street? That's what I want to know. That's what I want to know. That's a question that I want to ask. Can I thank everyone for their comments recently? Much appreciated. If you want to friend me on Facebook, I am on Facebook. Just go to Friends of Bamboo Joints. You will see me there. We have 6 members on there, and I hope we get more, because Bamboo Joints, I hope you will listen to that video also and watch that video also. That's another kick in the stomach for freedom. For freedom, for God's sake. Freedom to eat. Freedom to live in your own home. Freedom to have your daughter look after you and not some faceless person. Social services, all I would say is that they need to be investigated, sued, don't just sue the taxpayer of Coventry, sue the individual. They will soon learn in that way. Okay, well, I hope you like my apple blossom. I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks for your comments, thanks for your ratings, and don't forget Facebook, Friends of Bamboo Joints. You can friend me if you want to on Facebook. Bye for now. Bye.